Good morning. What's up? Welcome to the channel. This is Arctic Fox Studios. So today we'll be creating a patch using a variety of plugins, but we're mainly going to use the new VST from Dawesome called Abyss. We're going to start with a complete blank canvas and we'll see where we end up. So there's probably not going to be a whole lot of talking here, just mostly patch creation. But if you haven't seen Abyss yet, check it out in the link below. And if you want to skip through most of the creation, there are a few links in the description where you can see some key creation moments. So first, we're just going to start with the preview of some sounds. So a lot of these sounds are really good right out of the gate. Let's put on an ADSR curve here. What's really great about Abyss is it's so easy to build a good wavetable and then adjust it very quickly. I don't have a ton of plugins, but this is by far the easiest wavetable creation tool in my toolbox, at least. Everything else that I have, you have to kind of build the audio wave and then listen to it and then adjust it and then listen to it, and it's not as instantaneous as Abyss is. I'm going to try and put some reverb in here. Abyss's reverb is okay. I'd actually like to see some tweaks to it, but if you got a different out-of-the-box reverb that you can use, you can, you know, just add your flavor to it, which is what I'm going to do. I've been kind of favoring Rev Infinity by Arturia lately. It's just a very clean reverb. It doesn't color the sound a whole lot compared to some of the other ones. And then if you go down to the little LFO curve at the bottom, you can kind of put your own take on it and make it sound a bit more organic. So after going through this, I'm kind of feeling like the abyss portion of the patch is going to be more of a background sound. It's got a lot of movement to it, so let's try and turn it into a pad and maybe put it behind a keyboard or piano or something. I'm going to pull Falcon up and let's try a Rhodes sound to start. You can hear that little pitch shift in there. That's done by using a slight room size change in the reverb. Wow, that's actually sounding pretty cool. Let's see what kind of magic we can add with some UVI shade. Yeah, I think I like the butterfly effect out of all of those the best. And it's actually a pretty simple EQ mod if you want to create it on your own. Torn between keeping the frequency up high and dropping it down a bit. Let's try it and see what happens.
Thank you.
Just by itself, the Abyss patch is actually really amazing. I'm gonna save it and maybe we can make a few tweaks and see if we can make it even better. Wow, that sounds really, really good. I think we're pretty close to being done. Let's save this. So that pretty much sums it up for today. Thanks for watching if you've gotten this far, and please hit the like and subscribe if you would. I would really appreciate it, as this is a very small channel and we would like to grow a bit. If you like any of the products I'm showing off here today, there are links below to each one. And thanks again, and we will see you on the other side of the mountain.